بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وبعد. Today we have reached the lesson, the 23rd sitting. We've reached the 23rd sitting, بإذن الله تعالى. And inshallah we will continue from where Brother Wasim left off. And that's in the description of Jannah, the description of Jannah. So today's lesson is about the description of Jannah. So the Shaykh says, he says, المجلس الثالث والعشرون في وصف الجنة جعلنا الله من أهلها. So he says the 23rd sitting revolves around the descriptions of Jannah. May Allah make us from its people. Ameen. الحمد لله مبلغ الراجي فوق مأموله ومؤتي أسائلي زيادة على سؤله المنان على التائب بصفحه وقبوله خلق الإنسان وأنشأ دارا لحلوله وجعل الدنيا مرحلة لنزوله فتوطنها من لم يعرف شرف الأخرى لخموله وأخذ منها كارها قبل بلوغ مأموله ولم يغنه ما كسبه من مال وولد حتى انهزم في فلوله أو ما ترى غربان البين تنوح على طلوله أما الموفق فعرف غرورها فلم ينخدع بمثوله وسارع إلى مغفرة من الله وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض وعدت للذين آمنوا بالله ورسوله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له شهادة عارف بالدليل وأصوله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله ما تردد النسيم بين شماله وجنوبه ودبوره وقبوله صلى الله عليه وعلى أبي بكر صاحبه في سفره وحلوله ولا عمر الحامل الإسلام بسيف لا يخاف من فلوله ولا عثمان الصابر على البلاء حين نزوله ولا علي الماضي بشجاعته قبل أن يسول بنصوله وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان ما امتد الدهر بِطُولِهِ وَسَلَّمَ تَسْلِيمًا. So then the Shaykh says in his introduction, he begins with praising Allah and he says, all praise is due to Allah, the one who allows a hopeful person to reach beyond his goal, the one who gives more than what he has asked for, the one who is bounteous to the repentant by accepting his repentance. He created the human being and made the hereafter his abode and made this world as a path towards his destination. However, those who do not know the value of the perpetual abode which awaits them, the eternal abode that awaits them, have taken this world as their home due to their intellectual deficiency. They took from this world unlawfully before reaching their goal, but their wealth and children did not save them and will not save them from being destroyed. Do you not see the crows mourning over its ruins? But as for the one who is granted success, he recognizes the deceitfulness of this worldly life. Therefore, he is not deceived by its mirage. He competes towards seeking his Lord's forgiveness and obtaining the paradise which is more spacious than the heavens and the earth. And it has being prepared for those who believe in Allah and His Messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then the Shaykh says, he says, I bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped in truth except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone without a partner, a testimony of the one who knows the proof and his principles. And I also bear witness, as long as the gentle breeze continues to blow from all directions, that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is his slave and messenger. May Allah shower his blessings on him and on Abu Bakr, his companion, in his journeys and residency, on Umar radiallahu anhu, the one who defended al-Islam with a sword without the fear of failing, and Uthman radiallahu anhu, the one who was patient upon his test when it descended upon him, and upon Ali radiallahu anhu, the one who proceeded with his bravery before proceeding with his arrowhead, on his family members, his companions, and whoever follow their footsteps till the day of judgment. So that's the introduction. And then the Sheikh says, he says, oh my brothers, hasten towards seeking your Lord's forgiveness and rush towards seeking your Lord's forgiveness. A paradise which is more spacious than the heavens and the earth. In paradise there is that which the eye has never seen, the ear that has never heard, and the heart that has never even imagined. And Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala says, so we're going to read quite a few ayahs, and then what we'll do is we'll go through the translation, so bear with me. So the Shaykh says, he says, سَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجِنَّةِ أَرْضُهَا كَأَرْضِ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ فِيهَا مَا لَا أَيْنٌ رَأَتْ وَلَا أُذُنٌ سَمِعَتْ وَلَا خَطَرَ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِ بَشَرٍ قَالَ تَعَالَىٰ. So we've translated that already. So then these are the series of ayahs now with regards to paradise. Okay, so let's read them and then we'll go through the translation, inshallah. بِذْنَا تَعَالَىٰ. قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَىٰ مثل الجنة التي وعد المتقون تجري من تحتها الأنهار أكلها دائم وظلها. وقال تعالى مثل الجنة التي وعد المتقون فيها أنهار من ماء غير آسن وأنهار من لبن لم يتغير طعمه وأنهار من خمر لذة للشاربين وأنهار من عسل مصفى ولهم فيها من كل ثمرات ومغفرة من ربهم. وقال تعالى وبشر الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات أن لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار كلما رزقوا منها من ثمرات رزقا قالوا هذا الذي رزقنا من قبل وأوتوا به متشابها ولهم فيها أزواج مطهرة وهم فيها خالدون. وقال تعالى ودانية عليهم ظلالها وذللت قطوفها تذليلا ويطاف عليهم بآنية من فضة وأكواب كانت قواريرا من فضة قدروها تقديرا ويسقون فيها كأسا كان مزاجها زنجبيلا عينا فيها تسمى سلسبيلا ويطوف عليهم ولدان مخلدون إذا رأيتهم حسبتهم لؤلؤا منثورا وإذا رأيت ثم رأيت نعيما وملكا كبيرا. وقال تعالى في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمالق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة. وقال تعالى يحلون فيها من أساور من ذهب ولؤلؤا ولباسهم فيها حرير. وقال تعالى عاليهم ثياب سندس خضر استبرق واستبرق عليهم ثياب سندس خضر واستبرق وحلوا أساور من فضة. وقال تعالى متكئين على رفرف خضر وعبقري حسان. وقال تعالى متكئين فيها على الأرائك لا يرون فيها شمسا ولا زمهريرا. وقال تعالى إن المتقين في مقام أمين في جنات وعيون يلبسون من سندس وإستبرق متقابلين كذلك وزوجناهم بحور عين يدعون فيها بكل فاكهة آمنين وقال تعالى ادخلوا الجنة أنتم وأزواجكم تحبرون يطاف عليهم بالسحاف من ذهب وأكواب وفيها ما تشتهيه الأنفس وتلذ الأعين وأنتم فيها خالدون وتلك الجنة التي أورثتموها بما كنتم تعملون لكم فيها فاكهة كثيرة منها تأكلون إن المجرمين في عذاب جهنم خالدون وقال تعالى فيهن قاصرات الطرف لم يطمثهن إنس قبلهم ولا جان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان كأنهن الياقوت والمرجان وقال تعالى فيهن خيرات حسان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان حور مقصورات في الخيام وقال تعالى فلا تألم نفس ما أخفي لهم من قرة أعين جزاء بما كانوا يعملون وقال تعالى للذين أحسنوا الحسنى وزيادة ولا يرهق وجوههم فتر ولا ذلة أولئك أصحاب الجنة هم فيها خالدون فالحسنى هي الجنة لأنه لا دار أحسن منها وزيادة هي النظر إلى وجه الله الكريم رزقنا الله ذلك بمنه وكرمه والآيات في وصف الجنة ونعيمها وسرورها وأنسها وحبورها كثيرة جدا. So let's translate that now. So let's just I'll leave these out here because we'll go to the Quran inshallah. One second. Translate. So we'll stay here inshallah. Right. So we're going to go through the series of ayahs, then I'll quote the references as well, inshallah. So the first, starting from the beginning, the example of paradise which the righteous have been promised is that beneath it rivers flow, its fruit is lasting and its shade. That is a consequence for the righteous. That's Surah Al-Ra'd, verse 35. Then we have the description of paradise which the righteous are promised is that wherein are rivers of water, unaltered rivers of milk, the taste of which never changes, rivers of wine, delicious to those who drink, and rivers of purified honey in which they will have from all kinds of fruits and forgiveness from their Lord. Surah Muhammad, verse 15. And give good tidings, and give glad tidings to those who believe and do righteous deeds, that they will have gardens, that they will have gardens in paradise beneath which rivers flow. Whenever they are provided with the provision of fruit therefrom, they will say, this is what we were provided with before, and it is given to them in likeness, and they will have therein purified spouses, and they will abide therein eternally. Al-Baqarah 25. And near above them are its shades, and its fruit to be picked will be lowered in compliance, and there will be circulated among them vessels of silver and cups having been created clear as glass. Clear glass is made from silver of which they have determined the measure, and they will be given to drink a cup of wine whose mixture is of ginger from a fountain within paradise named Salsabil, and round about them will serve. There will be boys around them serving them of everlasting youth. If you see them, you would think them as beautiful as scattered pearls. And when you look therein, paradise, you will see pleasure and great dominion. Al-Insan, verse 14 to 20. In an elevated garden, wherein they will hear no unsuitable speech, within it is a flowing spring, within it are couches raised high and cups put in place and cushions lined up and carpets spread around. Al-Ghashiyah 10 to 16. Indeed, Allah will admit those who believe and do righteous deeds to gardens beneath which rivers flow. They will be adorned therein with bracelets of gold and pearls, and their garments therein will be silk. Al-Hajj 23. They will be reclining therein on adorned couches. They will not see therein any burning sun or freezing cold. Al-Insan 13. Upon the inhabitants will be green garments of fine silk and brocade, and they will be adorned with bracelets of silver, and their Lord will give them a purifying drink. Al-Insan, verse 21. Reclining on green cushions and beautiful fine carpets, Ar-Rahman, verse 76. Indeed, the righteous will be in a secure place, within gardens and springs, wearing garments of fine silk and brocade, facing each other. Thus, and we will marry them to fair women with large beautiful eyes. They will call therein for every kind of fruit, safe and secure. Ad-Dukhan, 51-55. Enter paradise, you and your kinds delighted. Az-Zukhruf, 70. In them are women limiting their glances untouched before them by man or jinni. So which of them favors of your Lord would you deny, as if they were rubies and coral? Ar-Rahman, verse 56-58. In them are good and beautiful women, so which of the favors of your Lord would you deny, fair ones reserved in pavilions? Ar-Rahman, 70-72. And no soul knows what has been hidden for them of comfort for eyes as reward for what they used to do. As-Sajda, verse 17. For them who have done good is Al-Husna and Ziyada. No darkness will cover their faces, nor humiliation. Those are companions of paradise. They will abide therein forever and eternally. Yunus 26. Then the Sheikh explains what does the word Husna mean. And he says the word Husna means paradise because there is no better than it. And as for the word Ziyada, what does Ziyada mean? In the last Quran ayah that we read there, Ziyada, he said that the ziyada, the meaning of ziyada, it means looking at the honorable face of Allah, the Most High. May Allah provide us out of His bounty and kindness with the honor of looking at His face. The Quranic verses about paradise descriptions, its favors, its joyfulness and pleasures are many. So then the Sheikh says that there's many descriptions within the Quran about paradise. And the biggest blessing, the biggest blessing that anybody can be given and be bestowed upon him by Allah is being able to see Allah's face. That's the biggest blessing. So and that's what the scholars they mention this, that is the hugest, that's the most biggest, the biggest blessing that you can have. So then the Shaykh continues and he says, وَأَمَّا الْأَحَدِيثُ فَعَنْ أَبِي هُرَيْرَةَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ قَالَ قُلْنَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ حَدِّثْنَا عَنِ الْجَنَّةِ مَا بَنَاؤُهَا قَالْ لَبِنَةُ ذَهَبٍ وَلَبِنَةُ فِدَّةٍ وَمِلَاتُهَا الْمِسْكُ وَأَصْبَاؤُهَا اللُّؤْلُؤَ وَالْيَاقُوتُ وَتُرَابُهَا الزَّعْفَرَانُ من يدخلها ينعم ولا يبعث ويخلد ولا يموت ولا تبلى ثيابه ولا يفنى شبابه رواه أحمد وترمذي. So what we'll do here, then the Shaykh says, as for the ahadith, then he quotes ahadith. So the first one's from on the authority of Abu Huraira. So what we'll do here is, instead of reading like we did with the Quran ayahs in a series and then translating them and getting the translation, what we'll do is we'll read the hadith one hadith at a time and then read the translation and we'll translate it inshallah as well. So the first hadith that we just read there, that is, it is narrated by Abu Huraira. We said, O Messenger of Allah, inform us about paradise and what is built of. He replied, bricks of gold and bricks of silver. Its mortar is musk. Its pebbles are pearls and rubies. Its sand is saffron. Whoever enters it will be blessed and will not be wretched and will remain forever and will never perish. His garment will never get faded and his usefulness will remain forever. Corrected by Tirmidhi, this narration mentioned by Sheikh Al-Albani as being Hassan. So, then let's go to the next hadith. عتبة بن غزوان رضي الله عنه أنه خطب فحمد الله وأثنى عليه ثم قال أما بعد فإن الدنيا قد آذنت بسرمي وولت حذاء ولم يبقى منها إلا سبابة كسبابة الإناء yastubbuha sahibuha wa innakum muntaqilun wa innakum muntaqiluna minha ila darin la zawala laha fantaqilu bi khairin ma yahdurannakum wa laqad dhukira lana anna misra'in min masari al-jannati baynahuma masiratu 40 sana wa liyatiyanna alayhi yawmun wa huwa kadidun min az-zihham. So then the Sheikh mentions another hadith which has been written by authenticated by a Muslim. We'll go through that as well. So then the Sheikh says, it is also narrated by Utba bin Ghazwan radiallahu anhu, who said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave a speech. He thanked and praised Allah and then said, and to proceed, indeed, the world has announced its departure and it is departing quickly. What is left from this world is like the little amount of water that is left in the bottom of a cup, which is quickly drunk by its owner, and you will soon depart from it to a home that remains forever. Therefore, proceed with the good that comes to you, for indeed we were informed that the distance between its two doors is a journey of 40 years, and a day will come to it when it will be filled from crowding, collected by Muslim. So let's go to the next hadith. So then the Shaykh says, وعن سهل بن سعد رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال في الجنة ثمانية أبواب فيها باب يسمى الريان لا يدخله إلا الصائمون متفق عليه. So then the Sheikh mentions another hadith. He says, it is narrated by سهل بن سعد رضي الله عنه, who said that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, in paradise there are 8 doors. One of these doors is named Rayyan. Only the fasting people will enter it. Collected by Al-Bukhari Muslim. So the people of fasting, the ones who used to fast and fast a lot, and used to be a habit of theirs of fasting, they will enter through that door, Rayyan. Then let's go to the next hadith. Then the Shaykh says, Wa'an Usama ibn Zayd radiallahu anhu, أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال ألا هل من مشمر إلى الجنة فإن الجنة لا خطر لها هي ورب الكعبة نور يتلألأ وريح وريحانة وحلل كثيرة ومقام في أبد في دار سليمة وفاكهة وخضرة و حبرة ونعمة في محلة عالية بهية. قالوا يا رسول الله نحن المشمرون لها. قال قولوا إن شاء الله. فقال القوم إن شاء الله. رواه ابن ماجة والبيهقي وابن حبان في صحيحه. So then the Shaykh quotes another hadith to us. He says, on the authority of Usama bin Zayd radiallahu anhu, who said that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, is there anyone who desires paradise? For verily there is nothing like paradise by the Lord of the Kaaba. It is an illuminating light. It is swinging basil, fortress castles, running rivers, ripened fruits, beautiful wives, many ornaments, eternal abode. There are fruits and vegetables. It is a place of jubilation, full of bounty and blessing with overwhelming glory. They said, O Messenger of Allah, we long for this paradise. We long for paradise. He said to them, say, Insha'Allah. And then they said, Insha'Allah. This hadith is just Sheikh Al-Albani graded it to be weak in Al-Albani, Dha'if Al-Targhib. And then the Shaykh continues and he says, وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن في الجنة 100 درجة عدها الله للمجاهدين في سبيله بين كل درجتين كما بين السماء والأرض فإذا سألتم الله فاسألوه الفردوس فإنه وسط الجنة وأعلى الجنة ومنه تفجر أنهار الجنة وفوقها عرش الرحمن رواه البخاري Walahu and Abi Sa'id radiallahu anhu. So then we'll just go through that one. There's two other hadith mentioned by narrated by Abu Huraira. So it is narrated by Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, who said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there are indeed hundred ranks in paradise that are prepared by Allah for those who fight for His sake. Between every rank is like the distance between the heaven and the earth. And if you ask Allah, then ask Him for Al-Firdaus. For verily, it is a middle of paradise and the highest level of paradise. From the middle to the highest level of paradise. And the spring of paradise gushes forth from it. And above it is the throne of the most beneficent Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Collected by Al-Bukhari. And it's also narrated by Abu Huraira as well. That the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he said here, he said, Inna ahl al-jannati yatara'una ahl al-ghurafi fawqahum kama tara'una al-kawkaba al-durriya al-ghabira fi al-ufuqi min al-mashriki aw al-maghribi litafaduli ma baynahum. Qalu, ya Rasulullah, تِلْكَ مَنَازِلُ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ لَا يَبْلُغُهَا غَيْرَهُمْ قَالَ بَلَى وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ رِجَالٌ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَصَدَّقُوا الْمُرْسَلِينَ وَأَنْ أَبِي. So we'll just stop there. So then the Shaykh says, it is also narrated by Abu Sa'id al-Khudri that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the people of Paradise will see their preferences in their castles from above them based on the virtues of their deeds, or the virtues of their deeds, just as you can see the glittering of the elapsing star in the horizons of the east or the west. They said, O Messenger of Allah, are those castles the abodes of the prophets which none can reach but they alone? He said, no, I swear by Him in whose hand is my soul, they are for men who believe in Allah and believe in the messengers. Collected by Al-Bukhari. And then the Shaykh says, وَعَنْ أَبِي مَالِكَ الْعَشْعَرِي رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ عَنْ أَبِي مَالِكَ الْعَشْعَرِي رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ أَنَّ النَّبِيَ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمْ قَالَ إِنَّ فِي الْجَنَّةِ غُرَفًا يُرَى ظَاهِرُهَا مِنْ بَاطِنِهَا وَبَاطِنِهَا مِنْ ظَاهِرِهَا عَدَّهَا اللَّهُ لِمَنْ أطعم الطعام وأدام الصيام وصلى بالليل والناس نيام أخرجه الطبراني. So then the Shaykh says, he quotes another ayah, and he says it is narrated by Abu Malik al-Ash'ari radiallahu anhu that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, surely in paradise there are houses which the inside could be seen from the outside and the outside could be seen from the inside. Allah prepared them for the one who fed the poor, fasted constantly and prayed in the night while the people were sleeping. Correct by At-Tabarani. And Al-Albani, Rahmullah, graded it to be authentic due to other corroborating narrations, as is found in his checking of Mishkat al-Masabih. Then, another hadith is mentioned, and it says, وَعَنْ أَبِي مُوسَى رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ أَنِ النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ قَالَ إِنَّ لِلْمُؤْمِنِي فِي الْجَنَّةِ لخيمة من لؤلؤة واحدة مجوفة طولها في السماء 60 ميلا للمؤمن فيها أهلون يطوف عليهم فلا يرى بعضهم بعضا متفق عليه. So then another hadith is mentioned here also, and it says, it is also narrated by Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiallahu anhu that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the believer has a boat-shaped tent in paradise, which is made of pearls. Its height is 60 miles. The believer has wives in it, and he will be with them one after the other without them seeing one another. Then the Shaykh mentions another hadith. He says, وَفِي صَحِيحِ مُسْلِمٍ عَنْ أَبِي هُرَيْرَةَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ أَنَّ النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ قَالَ إِنَّ أَوَّلَ زُمْرَةٍ تدخل الجنة على سورة القبر ليلة البدر ثم الذين يلونهم على أشد نجم في السماء إضاءة ثم هم بعد ذلك منازل لا يتغوطون ولا يبولون ولا يمتخطون ولا يبسقون أمشاتهم الذهب ومجامرهم الألوة ورشحهم المسك أخلاقهم على خلق رجل واحد على طول أبيهم آدم 60 ذراعا وفي رواية لا اختلاف بينهم ولا تباغض قلوبهم قلب واحد يسبحون الله بكرة وعشية وفي رواية وأزواجهم الحور العين وله من حديث جابر رضي الله عنه. So we'll just stop there for a second. I will just translate this. It is narrated by Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu that the Prophet ﷺ said that the first badges of believers or the first groups of believers who will enter paradise resemble the full moon in their beauty, and then the ones that follow them will resemble the brightest star in the sky in beauty. Then they will end up in houses where they will not defecate, urinate, blow their nose or spit. Their combs are made of gold, their grills are aloes, their sweat smells like musk. All of them have the same build, like the build of their father Adam. He was 60 cubits tall. And in other narrations, it says there is no disagreement amongst them or hatred. Their hearts are united. They glorify Allah every morning and evening. Narrated by Muslim. And in other narrations, it says their wives are the women with lovely eyes. So then we arrive at the hadith of Jabir, where the Shaykh said, he says, وَلَهُ مِنْ حَدِيثِ جَابِرَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ أَنَّ النَّبِيَ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ قَالَ إِنَّ أَهْلَ الْجَنَّةِ يَأْكُلُونَ فِيهَا وَيَشْرَبُونَ وَلَا يَطْفُلُونَ وَلَا يَبُولُونَ وَلَا يَتَغَوَّتُونَ وَلَا يَمْتَخِتُونَ قَالُوا فَمَا بَالُ الطَّعَامِ قَالَ جُشَاءٌ وَرَشْحٌ كَرَشْحِ الْمِسْكِ يُلْهَمُونَ التَّصْبِيحَ وَتَحْمِيدَ كَمَا يُلْهَمُونَ النَّفْسِ. So then the Shaykh mentions the hadith of Jabir radiallahu anhu, where he says that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, the people of paradise will eat and drink in it. However, they will not spit, urinate, defecate, or blow their nose. They said, O Messenger of Allah, how do we excrete the food? He said, it will ooze out of your body like the spray of musk, and they will be inspired with glorification and the praise of their Lord just as they breathe. Collected by Muslim. So then the Shaykh says, وَعَنْ زَيْدِ بْنُ أَرْقَمْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ أَنَّ النَّبِيَ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ قَالَ وَالَّذِي نَفْسُ مُحَمَّدٍ بِيَدِهِ إِنْ أَحَدَهُمْ يَأْنِي أَهْلَ الْجَنَّةِ لِيُؤْطَى قوة 100 رجل في الأكل والشرب والجماع والشهوة تكون حاجة أحدهم رشحا يفيض من جلودهم كرشح المسك فيضمر بطنه. أخرجه أحمد والنسائي. So let's read that hadith as well, which we read in Arabic. Let's read in English. It is narrated by Zayd ibn Arqam رضي الله عنه that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, I swear by him in whose hand is the soul of Muhammad, a man will be given the strength of 100 men in eating, drinking, and having sexual relations and desires. The excretion of one of them will be sweat of musk, which will ooze out of their skin and cause his belly to atrophy or to become larger. Narrated by Ahmad and Nasai with an authentic chain, Muqbil declared to be authentic in As-Sahih Al-Musnad, as well as Al-Albani in Sahih Al-Targhib. Yeah? So that's a Sahih Hadith. Let's keep reading. Bidhanai Ta'ala. So then, the Shaykh mentions another Hadith. He says, وَعَنْ أَنَسْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ أَنَّ النَّبِيَّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ قَالَ لِقَابِ قَوْسِ أَحَدِكُمْ أَوْ مَوْدِئِ قَدَمْ موضعي قدم في الجنة خير من الدنيا وما فيها ولو أن امرأة من نساء الجنة اطلعت إلى الأرض لأضاءت ما بينهما ولملأت ما بينهما ريحا ولنصيفها يعني الخمار خير من الدنيا وما فيها. رواه البخاري وعن أنس بن مالك. Okay, so we'll stop there. And translate this one as well. It is narrated by Anas radiallahu anhu, that the Prophet said, the space of a bow of one of you or the space of his footstep in paradise is better than the world and whatsoever is in it. And if a woman from the women of the people of paradise appear on this earth, she will illuminate whatsoever is between the heaven and earth and fill them up with a good smell. Her veil is better than the world and whatsoever is in them. Collected by Al-Bukhari. Then the Shaykh says, where were we here? وعن أنس بن مالك وعن أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن في الجنة لسوقا يأتونها كل جمعة فتهبوا ريح الشمال فتحثوا في وجوههم وثيابهم فيزدادون حسنا وجمالا فيرجعون إلى أهلهم فيقولون لهم والله لقد ازددتم بعدنا حسنا وجمالا فيقولون وأنتم والله لقد ازددتم بعدنا حسنا وجمالا رواه مسلم. So let's just stop there. So then the Shaykh mentions another hadith. He says, it is narrated by Anas radiallahu anhu that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, in paradise there is a market where the people of paradise gather every Friday. Then the north breeze of paradise will blow on their faces and garments, causing them to increase in beauty. They will then return back to their wives, and their wives will say to them, by Allah, you have increased in beauty after you have left us and came back. And they will also say to their families, by Allah, you have also increased in beauty. Collected by Muslim. Then the Shaykh says, وَلَهُ عَنْ أَبِي سَعِيدٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ أَنَّ النَّبِيَّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ قَالَ إِذَا دَخَلَ أَهْلُ الْجَنَّةِ الْجَنَّةَ يُنَادِي مُنَادٍ إِنْ لَكُمْ أَنْ تَصِحُّوا فَلَا تَسْقِمُوا أَبَدًا وَإِنْ لَكُمْ أَنْ تَحْيَوْا فَلَا تَمُوتُوا أَبَدًا وَإِنْ لَكُمْ أَنْ تَشِبُّوا فَلَا تَحْرُمُوا أَبَدًا وَإِنْ لَكُمْ أَنْ تَنَعَمُوا فَلَا تَبْعَثُوا أَبَدًا وَذَلِكَ قَوْلُ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ وَنُودُوا أَنْ تِلْكُمُ الْجَنَّةُ أُورِثْتُمُوهَا بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. So then, the Shaykh says, starting from the beginning, he says, it is narrated by Abu Sa'id radiallahu anhu, who said that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when the people of paradise enter paradise, a caller will proclaim, saying, indeed yours is to live healthy and never fall sick, and to live forever without dying, and to remain young without growing old, and to enjoy ceaselessly without wretchedness. And this is the interpretation of Allah's statement. And they will be called, this is paradise which you have been made to inherit for what you used to do. Surah Al-A'raf, verse 43. Yeah. Then the Shaykh continues and he says, okay, the last page. This is the last page, alhamdulillah. So then the Shaykh continues and he says, وَفِي الصَّحِيحَيْنِ عَنْ أَبِي هُرَيْرَةَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ أَنَّ النَّبِيَّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ قَالَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ أعددت لعبادي الصالحين ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على قلب بشر وأقرأوا إن شئتم فلا تألم نفس ما أخفي لهم من قرة أعين جزاء بما كانوا يعملون. وعن صحيب رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إذا دخل أهل الجنة الجنة نادي مناد يا أهل الجنة إن لكم عند الله موعدا يريد أن ينجزكموه فيقولون ما هو ألم يثقل ما هو ألم يثقل موازيننا ويبيض وجوهنا ويدخلنا الجنة ويزحزحنا عن النار أو يزحزحنا عن النار. قال فيكشف لهم الحجاب فينظرون إليه فوالله ما أعطاهم الله شيئا أحب إليهم من النظر إليه ولا أقر لأعينهم منه. رواه مسلم وله من حديث أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه أن الله يقول لأهل الجنة أهن عليكم رضواني فلا أسخط عليكم بعده أبدا. So then the Sheikh says, it is narrated by Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allah Jalla wa'ala said, I have prepared for my pious slaves in paradise that which the eye has never seen, the ear has never heard, and has never come across the heart of any mortal person. Any person never come across any person. They've never imagined it. Then he said, recite if you will. And no soul knows what has been hidden for them of comfort for eyes as a reward for what they used to do. Surah Al-Sajda, verse 17. Collected, and the hadith is collected by Al-Bukhari and Muslim. Then it is narrated by Suhaib radiallahu anhu that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, when the people of paradise enter paradise, a caller will proclaim, saying, O people of paradise, you have with your Lord a promise which he wants to fulfill for you. So they will say, what is the promise? Has he not made our scales heavy? Has he not made our faces delighted? Has he not placed us in paradise and distanced us from the hellfire? Then Allah will remove the veil and they will look at him. By Allah, Allah has not given them anything that is more beloved to them and more pleasant for their eyes than them looking at him. Collected by Muslim. Also narrated by Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu, who said, Allah will say to the people of paradise, I will send down my pleasure upon you and never will I be angry at you ever again. Collected by Muslim. And then the Shaykh says, Allahumma razuqna al-khulda fi jananik wa alayna fiha wa hilla alayna fiha ridwanak wa razuqna ladhat al-nadri ila wajhik والشر والشوق إلى لقائك من غير ضراء مضرة ولا فتنة مضلة اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على عبدك ونبيك محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. So then the Shaykh says, he makes a dua and he says, the rough translation of it being, O Allah, grant us eternity in your paradise and send down on us your pleasure and sustain us with the sweetness of looking at your face and the aspiration of meeting with you without any harm or misleading temptation. O Allah, send peace and salutations and blessings to your slave and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his family members and all his companions. So alhamdulillah, we conclude there and we'll see you around about the same time tomorrow, inshallah, where Brother Wasim will continue the lesson with Nayi Ta'ala. Barakallahu feekum. Subhanakullahu wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.